I'm hoping you like beautiful images and a wide array of wavelengths, because I have a couple of doozies to show you. And two exoplanets only a few times more massive than Earth have been detected in a mere 13 light years away. And no, it wasn't observed with Kepler. Hello space fans, welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. Now it's really easy to think that when I say exoplanet discovered, you immediately think the Kepler Space Telescope. However, this is not the case today. In fact, these two exoplanets were confirmed using ground-based telescopes from around the world. Using data from the HARP spectrometer from ESO's La Silla Observatory in Chile, Hi-Res from the Keck Observatory on Mauna Kea, Hawaii, and the planet-finding spectrometer at Las Campanas Observatory, astronomers found two planets orbiting Kapteyn star. The star received its name by the man who discovered it in 1898, Jacobus Kapteyn, and it is not a native to our galaxy. Using advanced scientific modeling, astronomers see that Kapteyn's star came from a merger of a smaller dwarf galaxy around 400 million years ago. The two planets orbiting this red dwarf star are 4.5 and 7 solar masses each, with their orbital period being around 48 and 120 days, respectively. What's even better is that Kapteyn b, the planet closest to the star, is residing in the habitable zone and has the potential to host liquid water on its surface. This star and its planets are incredibly old, far older than our solar system. Current estimates place Kapteyn's system at around 11.5 billion years old. That's 2.5 times the age of our star, or a mere 2 billion years younger than the Big Bang. My favorite part of this press release is a beautiful piece written by science fiction author Alistair Reynolds, from the point of view of an advanced spacecraft with artificial intelligence, writing home to share the wonder of this discovery.
I know, I've taken liberties. I should have transmitted my wake-up signal before doing any investigations, but I couldn't resist myself. You made me to be curious. I found signs of civilization. The first planet, Kapteyn b, still lies within the habitable zone of the star, orbiting once every 48 days. There's nothing living there now, not even an atmosphere, but once there was a technological culture. Yes, the first I found, the reason I was made in the first place. How's that for a discovery?
I've placed links to the full writing in the description below, and I definitely recommend giving it a read. It's simply beautiful. So speaking of beauty, two of the most beautiful images I've ever seen have been released this past week. Let's take a look at the first, M51, the Whirlpool Galaxy. The Chandra X-ray Observatory has used over 1 million seconds of observation time to add to this gorgeous image of this galactic merger that Hubble has taken in optical wavelengths. Adding the Chandra data in purple reveals spectacular events happening within the galaxy, X-ray binaries. These happen when a star is orbiting either a super-dense neutron star or a black hole, causing its matter to fall in towards its massive companion, heating it to millions of degrees and sending out extremely energetic rays of light. 400 X-ray sources in this image are believed to be within M51 itself, with the remainder being either between the galaxy and us or beyond it. That's compared to only 100 that were observed with the previous studies from Chandra. Investigating galaxies like M51 in X-ray wavelengths allows scientists to get a better understanding of how sources containing black holes act over time, giving better insight into their evolution. Add to it the immense beauty of combining observations from Hubble with this new data, and it's a breathtaking display of how amazing the universe is. Finally, one of the crown jewels from Hubble has received even more glimmer from additional wavelengths. The Hubble Ultra Deep Field is arguably one of the most spectacular images ever taken in human history. It was captured during 841 orbits, each taking a 90-minute exposure to bestow upon us the beauty of what appears to be empty space. That's like keeping your camera open for 52.5 days, pointing at nothingness, and seeing 10,000 galaxies emerge. The additional ultraviolet detection was brought from the Wide Field Camera 3 and gives astronomers further access into the rich history of the universe, particularly in the birth and evolution of hot, massive stars during the time when star formation first started occurring. You might as well forget the desktop wallpaper you have now and replace it with one of these. I already have. Well, that's it for this week, space fans. Thank you all for watching. Starting on the 12th of June, Space Fan News will be jumping in with Hubble Hangouts that will occur nearly every Thursday for the foreseeable future. If you have any questions for the Hubble team on anything, let us know in the comments below and they just might get answered on air. We also had a conversation with Dr. Katie Mack this weekend on gamma ray bursts that was extremely insightful. Click here, 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 right there to watch it. If you enjoyed this, please feel free to give us a thumbs up and to subscribe for more. You can also find us on Twitter at SpaceFanNews and our Tumblr is spacefannews.com. Well, I will see you later, space fans, and as always, keep looking up.